Hi, this is Nick Baby Love Salerno, a graduate of North High 1970. I just, from all my heart, it's the 15th anniversary of hip hop in North High Polar Bears. We are the Polar Bears. We are strong. What you've done is increíble, incredible. Congratulations to every student ever at North High and everybody in Central New England, especially Worcester, Mass., where I was born. God bless you, North High basketball state champions, world champions forever. 2023. This is about North High, but we're gonna go back in the history of the high school, which we played at Forest Hill Junior High Gym. We didn't have a gym. Every game was a road game. And Marty O'Malley is the greatest coach. He was there 30 years in history. He knew everybody across the country. He taught me, just like all the players we're gonna mention, starting with Sonny Jim Price. You know what I mean? Just probably the greatest player in the history of North High. For 3 years, even as a freshman, I don't know what to say. He went on to become a Hall of Fame member of Worcester State College. Sonny Jim Price, you know I love you. We're gonna put up the screenshots. You know, the last time we spent a week together, I was with MC Hammer in the 80s. And you tell everybody the story how you drove us to the airport and hung out. That was before Stanley Kirk Burrell became the famous MC Hammer. The next guy up on the Hole in the Wall crew. Gene Spoonspan played at Holy Name, but he's an honorary member of the Hole in the Wall. It's really the Hole in the Wall gang, but I want to be politically correct. Gene is a lifetime friend. He's in Philly, but he's happy like everybody else. This is about Worcester and familiar in Italian. You know, familia in Spanish, family in English. This is about North High, you players and the coaches and the students and the faculty. You know, we're so proud because North was always the underdog. Like I said, the high school was in two or three different locations. Now you got a new one. Even though I'm legally blind cancer survivor, Nick Baby Love here, I can't wait to come up and film with the filmmakers. Bottom line is Gene Spahn, man, I love you, brother. Go to my next OG there.
Danny DKB Brand.
Danny Brand is a friend for 60 years. His picture is in the shot with me, with Marty O'Malley behind me. It's a rare, rare picture. Danny's on Cape Cod, big time, you know, consultant, contractor, owns stores with his wife Maria and his whole family, Evelyn and Cecily. I'm mentioning that because they're all big North High fans, and both Danny and Maria graduated with me in 1970 from the incredible state champion Polar Bears North High. Don't get me started. Phil Mac Daddy Fisher went to St. John's. He was the first black kid to enter St. John's High, and he is for life in the Hole in the Wall crew, as we're saying. Phil, actually, there's a picture of him and President Clinton. And what's most important, before this started, Phil Fisher, God rest his, you know, father's soul, who I was very tight with, and his brother Eddie and his wife, her, your picture's up there if I forgot your name, they donated to the team at the beginning of the season, so maybe they're the ones, like everybody else, supporting them, you know, gave the team the inspiration to just go on and do the impossible. You know what I mean? It's just like trying to pick a hit record to go against 1,000 schools, and they're not just Massachusetts state champions. When I finish with this, hey, worldwide champions. Coach Louis Graham, another one. Send me some pictures, bro. He was the first black coach. The kid is incredible. He told me stories about he used to hang out at my house with my dad and all that, like everybody else. He used to feed everybody, you know, back in the day. Louis, I love you, brother, for life. Jumpin' Jack Flagler, he's on tour now somewhere. I think he went to North. Just a great guy. And he is an original member of, like you said, the Hole in the Wall crew. Go ahead. Yeah. Artie Gazelle, the greatest point guard in the history of North High. Just, he's in there because he's got flavor. You follow me? Like, I'm considered a brother, honestly. Because that's the way I was brought up. That's why I'm so, you know, successful in the music business. I'm an executive. I started off as a DJ at Green Street Cafe in Worcester. Then BJ's Disco, very big, with BJ Dean at WRC. I worked at WAAF for Judge Corsi. I did WEIM in Fitchburg. I did WNEB with the guy who invented Nick Baby Love, Kenny Caperso, WNEB, and that's when I first broke Tavares from New Bedford. They're even happy about this. I talked to the group. They're beside themselves because they know Worcester is a very, very special place. You know, Jimmy Stovall, a great athlete, player, one of my best friends in life. You know, we don't agree on a few things, but Jimmy is going to be part of this. He used to come down. We went to all the baseball games because it's spring training in Florida. He's traveled, been all over the world with me, been to New York. How's this? We went to a Yankees-Red Sox game with Tom Silverman because my greatest thing ever is I'm known for breaking not only MC Hammer by myself, but Afrika Bambaataa because it's the 50th anniversary of hip-hop. It's a very big deal. And here we go, North High, state worldwide champions on the 50th anniversary. And Jimmy Stovall, very important part of my life. God bless him and his family. I love them all. They treated me very kindly over the years and taught me about soul music. And that is a big deal. That's why I am Nick Baby Love today. Go ahead.
Bobby V.
Bobby Vartanian, man, just a classy dude, like Sonny Jim Price, the greatest player that ever played at North, took us to the, we were fighting for the state championship, and of course, because I couldn't score, I was a great rebounder, I set the record of 26 rebounds, but Bobby V always and Sonny Jim screaming at me, pass us the ball, because we know you ain't going to shoot and you're going to blow the shot. So, Bobby V, I love you. You're quite a character. You know, like I said, you know, it's all good, brother. Yes, Jack the Shot Foley is probably, went to Holy Cross. That's another thing. Shout out to Worcester. This helps everybody. And even my people at Patriots Radio, patriots.com, that honored me on December 6th. 2017, it's all documented from the announcer Bob Sorcy to Mike DeSalt. He is a graduate of Holy Cross. Many people went there. And so Jack the Shot Foley, there's a book written that's a bestseller. And I hope he gets together with me on this whole thing because this North High thing is going to go on forever. They're going to repeat as we talk about the two songs that are exclusive, that are mine, that I am the executive producer from. They came out in the 80s, but I thought it was appropriate. Anyway, you know, Jack the Shot Foley has a book that was written with my honorary godfather, Togo Palazzi, knows all the Salerno family, the Black Orchid restaurant. I grew up on Shrewsbury Street. Jack the Shot Foley was written by Mark, the Pathfinder, Epstein, the most famous author ever to come out of Massachusetts or anywhere. He's just a brilliant author. This book, watch what he does with the next thing, because he's going to write Bagman, which is my book, and we're going to do a whole story on North High, period. Okay, without me starting to cry, Marty O'Malley and you, O'Malley, has been all over me on Facebook with Mark Epstein and everybody else, Artie Gazelle. They're like big Facebook people. And me being who I am, you know, I do a thing for a guy in New York, Ray Caviano. I'm an executive, so you all understand. But I do other things. And so, as Coach O'Malley, I know you're in heaven. You're still talking to me. You're in my ear. There he goes, Nick Salerno, being a little bit convoluted. You know, he used to stay on my butt. And in the picture that is with me and him, that's going to be prominent because we enlarged it. Huff and Quincy Washington and Kim Anderson, who played on the team. It was like the White Shadow, the old TV show, a predominantly black team with Artie Gazelle and Bobby Vartanian. It's just very, very important. Coach O'Malley taught me about life, everything. I used to go and meet him at the church after I graduated St. Bernard's before I got an offer to spin, you know, in Florida at the famous club during spring break, The Button. So Marty O'Malley knew everybody across the country. He coached for 30 years. He is the foundation to North High. And he did it, like I said, we had nothing to work with. Every game was a road game. So again, you O'Malley, thank you. Your dad was the greatest. And I am what I am today. He's one of my top mentors in my life, amongst many other people. You'd be surprised who mentored me. And, you know, I love you, Marty. God bless you and your family.
Hold it.
This North High thing is going to go on forever. Peace out.